Oh, well, hold on, that's probably not right. It was probably a dragon attack, uh-huh. Dragons, I hear, are very common in this area. These are nice boots. So, a prince is fighting a dragon, and then the dragon burns the prince down to nothing. But the boots survived because, surprise, they're magic boots.
Seriously, Macy, I can put up with your crazy imagination today. It's getting late.
Yeah, but there's no ashes in here, so that's probably not right. Okay. A psychopath murdered some lady and then left the boots here as a clue.
No, Macy, I bet these shoes were so unloved that they just couldn't take it no more, so they ran away from home. But now they're lost and it's up to us to save them.
Yeah, all right. I will save them.
Hello, this is Petey Fisk speaking to you for the Greater Tuna Humane Society. And I would just like to ask each of you to take a minute to think about ducks. It's tough being a duck. Cartoons portray ducks as genetic mutants with speech impediments. And the very word duck, when used as a verb, means to rapidly lower body position to avoid injury. So when you say duck to someone, they don't know whether you're talking about a bird or an accident. And the Chinese eat their feet. Now, you may not know this, but we have a duck crisis situation right here in Tuna. Mm-hmm. Ever since the government flooded Buckner Basin, the wild ducks have no nesting grounds left. We are up to our necks in homeless ducks. To remedy the situation, the Humane Society has published a pamphlet, Duck Trapping Without Trauma. And we're sending copies to every home in the Tuna area. So you bring them trap ducks to me, Petey Fisk, and I will personally relocate them into unflooded areas. This has been Petey Fisk speaking to you for the Greater Tuna Humane Society. Thank you.
Thank you, Petey. Thank you very much. Now it's time for
you. Have a lovely mouth.
Thank you.
I can tell that you're deeply emotional. I want you to have my children.
Thank you, but I don't like men who cry. I think men should be strong.
You cry like Bob then.
Who?
You know.
Oh.
I'm not irritating you.
No, it's just hard to get to know someone. Also, the waiter never comes. I really like
the order. Let's start all over again. Hello, my name is Bruce.
Hello.
Prudence. That's a lovely name.
Thank you.
That's a lovely dress.
Thank you. I like your necklace. It goes nicely with your chest hair.
Thank you. I like your nail polish.
Thank you. I have it on my toes, too.
Let me see. I think it's wonderful that you feel free enough with me to put your feet on the table.
I didn't put my feet on the table. I put one foot. I was hoping it would get the waiter's attention.
We agree on everything. It's amazing.
I just can't believe this isn't even the first time this has happened to us.
Come on, Birdie. Everything's great. It's beautiful outside. Hey, look up there. Those squirrels are sharing a little acorn. How cute is that?
I can see anything. These drops of optometrist gave still haven't worn off. And no, Macy, no. Everything is not great. I tell you constantly to turn the lights off, otherwise it hurts the car.
Well, I don't mean to hurt Petunia. It's just that she looks so radiant with all her lights on.
Sure, Macy, but that killed the battery.
What? Right, turn off the lights. I'm sorry, Petunia. Aww. I'm a negligent parent.
No more novellas for you. They make you too dramatic. We need to go find someone to give us a jump.
Wait.
Let's go!
Be right back, baby.
Why so serious?